the cell formula. So using this formula, you can get the active cell address or column or row, contents, type, prefix and the other options. So let's see how we can use the cell formula. Equal sign, cell of, then in the drop down we have lot of options: address, column, color, contents, file name. So let's use file name for now. Just double click and close the bracket. Now you can see the exact file name of this, or else if you want to use cell of address, if you want to see the active cell address, you can do that H5. Like this you can use the cell function. System info, for that you need to use equal sign info of, then in the drop down list we have directory, number, file, origin, OS version, release, system. So let's see the system, operating system. What is the system I am using? Just double click on the system and enter PCDOS. This is the system we are using. And if you want to see the Excel version or anything, using the info we can see. Equal info. Unfortunately, I do not have the release 14.0. Perfect. And length formula. So it will returns the number of characters in the particular text frame. Particular, it's not a text frame, it can be numeric or anything. It will also consider the space. Equal sign len of, you need to select the particular text. Done. So within this, you know, range C4, there is 11 texts are available, including the space. So space also considered as one of the text. 11, 14, 12, 7. Like this, it has many text. And the file name. So using the equal sign cell of file name, we can get the file name. Already we got the round. So it will round a number to a specified number of digits. Like on the column C, we have a multiple numbers, right? 1.47, something like that. If you want to round this, you can use the formula round of C4 comma D4. How you want to round it, which means how many places to round. Equal sign round of, then you want to select the number first. Next, number digits. So how many digits you want. If you want to 1, you can do that after the dot symbol. So how much you want. You want only 0, you can do that. Round of 3, 4, something like that, you can do using this round formula. It will round the specified number of digits. Round down. So round down, round up, everything is same, but it will down on values. Round down. First you need to select the number, then comma, number digits, how much number you want. 1.4, it will down one more value. So if the value is 1.67 something, it will down one more values to the particular range. Round up. Here you can see it's equal round up for this comma, this one. So now it has been considered as 2. Previously it was 1. Now it's rounded up with 2. Since this is going up, previously it was down. Round and round down will round the up down values. But using the rounded up, you can increase the values. Since this 1.47 should be part of 1, right? It's not exceeding the 1.5. So if the value is exceeding 1.5, it should be in the 2 category. But at this time, we are going to use roundup formula. So using the roundup formula, you can increase one more values to that. An odd function. So using the odd function, you can round it to the next odd number. Odd equal sign odd of, so here we have odd numbers, right? 2, 3, 3.9, something like that. So it will round it to the next odd number. It will help you to round it. Now you can see everything has been rounded perfectly. Minimum value. So using the minimum formula, you can get the, calculate the minimum value. Min, then you need to select the particular range. What is the minimum value available within this particular range? 100. Yes, 100 is the minimum value within that. Max using for maximum value. Ran between. So ran between allow you to range number of, you know, number of text that you want to be assigned. Ran between that. Equal sign ran between bottom. How much value you want? So 2, 15. So within that it will give you the ran values. So now I need between 2 to 15, I need a random number. So it's giving me the random number as 8. Is odd. So using this is odd, you can validate, is it odd number or no, is it not an odd number? Is odd. Using this formula, you can get the exact results, whether the value is true or false. Done. So one of the values is error, right? Since the value is text string, that's the reason it's displaying error. The other values are numeric values. Numeric values are also, you know, date and everything. It will display the exact results. And the code. Equal sign, code of, you need to select the particular letter. It will give you the code for the particular values. So each and everything in the single characters, Windows to identify each keyboard character, right? There is a keyboard keys or everything. Here is the keyboard letters. Mode formula. Equal sign, mode of, you need to select, sorry, mode of, select the particular range. This function will display the most frequently occurring number in a group of numbers. Most frequently occurring numbers. So 10 is the most frequent numbers, right? Repeated numbers. So it's displaying the 10 values. Convert. Converted to amount. So if you want to amount to convert, you can do that using this formula. It's equal convert of C4 comma D4 to E4 INCM. Year or date or anything. Now it's not only recommended for the amount, either you can now change this to year, day or anything you can change. Split. So using this formula, you can split the values. So unfortunately, I do not have a split option now. Let's see in the next session. Show all formulas. In order to show all the formulas, just go to the formulas tab and click on show formulas option. Now you can see all the formula has been displayed. So in order to hide that, just click on again show formulas. Done.